great tour. We're talking to students at universities, we're visiting churches and talking to community members, and it's really for people to have a chance to hear about what is the reality of working conditions in the garment industry and what can you do as a consumer, as an activist, as a taxpayer, as a person of faith, to support workers in their struggles.
What's happened is that there's just been this huge disconnection and alienation, and I think what we're trying to do is to build relationship, right? And so I think the violence that has been done is against recognizing these people as human beings, and that the way to restore this is to be in relationship, and through our relationship, through our solidarity, that's how we're able to make changes to a more peaceful, compassionate economic system.
Ha sido muy una buena experiencia para mí, porque ha sido una nueva oportunidad que nunca la había tenido y veo que sí es algo de provecho.
It's been a good experience for me, something new that I never experienced before, and I'm great to take advantage of.
Côté nous des jeunes comme si mon était plus arrêté, nous qui ouais plus dévouement comme c'est pour le bataille c'est dans l'université Cornell.
He felt that one of the places that he felt the people were really motivated to support us in solidarity was to Cornell University students.
C'est pas que l'autre côté ou pas comme si il y a un dévouement comme si pour
développer like the other didn't
pour aider nous gourmets dans bataille là, mais quand même l'université Cornell c'est différent comme si il y a un pied devant eux même il y a marché.
Okay, it's not that we didn't have a warm welcome everywhere, but at this particular place you can feel it, you can understand, you can see that the people were really motivated to change and to support what we're doing, to listen and to maybe to act. And now I feel that this is the place where things could move on forward.
Parce que vous le temps dans pratique ça, faire pression sur les compagnies pour ouvrir des meilleurs traitements.
Ok, it looks like they have already experience in supporting workers, so they are more equipped, they are more mature in this type of solidarity support.
Sí, ha sido muy solidario en cuanto a la gira. Sí, les agradecemos mucho por el apoyo que hemos tenido de la donde hemos compartido nuestra presentación.
We felt a lot of solidarity and support during the tour, and we really thank everybody who is joining the fight for workers' rights.
So I've been traveling with them around the state, and you know, I'm new to this. I started at Labor Religion Coalition in July, and I have to say before that, I did not give any thought to where my clothes come from. They come from the mall, and so. Part of my work, both before this week and especially during this week, is to not only realize what's really going on, but realize the human beings that are involved. Because a lot of times, I mean, when you have arguments over should we pay an additional 7 cents, this isn't really a question of money. This is a question of being able to treat these workers as human beings, right? They're not allowed to sit down. They're sometimes not allowed to take bathroom breaks. They're, you know, getting paid pennies. And so I guess that's what strikes me most, is that they're not, yesterday Yannick said, as people of faith, we are brothers and sisters, but in the factories, we are not brothers and sisters. We are not even human beings. And I guess that's why I take away from this event.
What strikes me is about the community people, like the coalition, labor and religious and communities, and working together. And that strikes me because we don't have that aspect in our country. So I think I look at it as an example, something to follow and see maybe what I'm doing, you know, union works, and I should get involved more with the community so that the workers will have a better support, because the workers are part of the community. So at least they should be informed about what's going on in the working place, and then and get the support of the community, and also have the workers and to the union to support the communities too. And so I think that's one of the things that I learned from the trip so far.
When we were in Syracuse, the workers really wanted to go into the bookstore, so we went into the bookstore and we were looking at the clothing. The first shirt that we pulled up was a Gildan shirt made in Haiti. And so it was this incredible experience to be in the store, to see the t-shirts with the workers. And so you look at this t-shirt, $12.99, and then you're with Telemark and you know he gets 3.5 cents, you know, for this shirt. And so it's just, yeah, it's an incredible experience to be with the clothing and the workers at the same time.
I was
fighting when I saw that. I was really fighting. I was really, this is completely out of it.
Nous recommandons yo avant yo à un prix comme si vraiment élevé et puis il va pas nous aucune satisfaction dans ça.
Okay, the question I was really completely surprised and even frightened to see the gap between what we are earning and how much they're selling and the apparel. So I was really it was unbelievable for me.
So the other thing that I think Yanni did a really good job of talking about is that the power that we have as consumers. And I think we often feel helpless and we ask, what can we do as individuals? But Yanni talks about how, you know, the workers who produce the goods need to organize, and the consumers who buy the goods need to organize, and it is together that we make these changes for the factories, and that it's together in pressuring the brand that these changes are able to happen. So I think that's a really important takeaway from today's event.
I think it was an important presentation, especially because the discussion of fair trade usually is done in an individual customer level. And we need to move from that into institutional, how do we build organizations that would allow for this. It's not about feeling guilty because you bought one thing or the other, or because you didn't have the extra money for the fair trade, but it's how do we make those options the standard in our nation.
So at universities, students are urging their universities to join the Worker Rights Consortium. A number of schools in New York are already part of the Worker Rights Consortium. It includes 180 campuses around the country. And at universities, then students can get involved in also promoting Alta Gracia, which is a factory that makes clothing under the Alta Gracia label that's in the Dominican Republic, where workers earn a living wage and have an independent union that is respected on the job. And with our community events, we're talking about the responsibility of the state of New York, and also as taxpayers, how we can work to ensure that our tax dollars aren't supporting poor working conditions. So the state of New York has already joined the Sweat Free Purchasing Consortium and is a leader in the consortium, which is really excellent. And on this tour, we're asking the state to take the next step, which is to live up to its promise of ending exploitation in the garment industry and factories producing apparel and public employee uniforms for the state by adopting a solid Sweat Free Procurement policy that puts into practice in the day-to-day purchasing of the state government to work toward making sure that the factories are made public of where the products are coming from, that labor laws are respected in those factories, and to work over time to have a way to work toward improving wages in the factories.
What I would like to say, so they understand, in we explain what's going on at the workplace, that the workers need respect for the rights as workers, respect, you know, human rights, you know, as human being. But it doesn't mean that we don't want people to buy the clothes that we are making in any country, in the Caribbean or, you know, Central America or in Asian country. And it's just that we feel that as consumers that you have a leverage, you can tell the companies that you are buying from that you need they are to change things in at the workplace, being that even if they don't own the factories, but since they are the one who are giving the orders, the production, whatever, so they paying for this, so at least they could demand that the workers get a fair share. So we want people to continue to buy. We want people to put pressure tell, you know, every now and then send a postcard to the company, tell them you are looking at what they're doing and you want to make sure that they change it, because you are in contact with the unions, and it's very important that if you do that, and if they, let's say the local factory owners are not abiding by, let's say, the code of conduct or other requirements that the companies have signed with the union, so, you know, you will be informed about it, and every time you inform about it, as little that it can be, you could send a postcard to the brand and tell them, make sure they took corrective measures to change these things, because you are supporting the workers and you want to continue to buy the products that the workers are making. You know, that's what we want to convey to all people, that it's not a question of not buying. Actually, more you buy, the more you have leverage in the company to tell them, okay, you are making profits out of what we are buying, but the workers, the ones who are producing them, they have to get their fair share. I think this is a message that I want to pass.